Okay, after introducing the different multi-GPU training strategies, let's now dive deeper into data parallelism and see how it works under the hood. So suppose we have a mini batch that is slightly too large to fit into GPU memory. What we can do is we can split that mini batch into multiple smaller mini batches. And then we can put each of these sub mini batches, which we also sometimes call micro batches, onto a different GPU. And then we take the model that we want to train and make multiple copies of that and place one copy along with the micro batch onto a different GPU. Now, if each GPU has a copy of the model with a different micro batch, what we can do is we can run all these training forward and backward passes in parallel. So each GPU here operates now independently on a copy of the model. Then after performing the forward and the backward passes, we average the gradients, use the average gradient to update the weights, and send the weights back to the GPUs to update the model copies here. And yeah, this is how data parallelism works in a nutshell. But before we move on, I wanted to give you a brief note about the implementation details here. So in particular, how data parallelism differs from regular backpropagation. Note here at the top, in regular backpropagation, we compute the loss, the gradients, and the weight updates based on the whole mini batch. Now in data parallelism, we compute the losses here for each micro batch, and then we average the gradients, and then we perform the weight update, which is a subtle difference here. So essentially, instead of computing the gradients based on the whole data set, we are computing multiple gradients here on smaller data sets that we average. And due to this aspect in regular data parallel, not the distributed version, what we have to do is we have to keep in mind the linear scaling rule here. So that means if each GPU has a smaller micro batch and we use these average gradients, we can think of that as smaller batch sizes. So we have to modify the learning rate accordingly. So in this video, we saw a brief introduction to data parallel. And in the next video, we will talk about distributed data parallel, which is actually the recommended strategy in practice.